Welcome to the online tutorial for Vidyabhavan Higher Secondary School. This video is for class 12 biology. In this video, I will continue with the chapter Molecular Basis of Inheritance that I have started with you. And I will discuss in today's video, I will discuss the positive effect or positive control of the lab operator. In the previous video, we have learned about the negative effect and negative control. In today's video, we will read about the positive effect. So, let's start with it. So, the positive effect of lab operator. So, after this negative effect, many scientists are there who explore this operon gene and provided with the theory that it has a positive gene. Like the negative gene is I, or the negative gene I is the negative gene. Similarly, like that of negative gene, there is a positive gene. What is the positive gene? It is known as CRP. Okay, this CRP is the positive gene. It induces the production of the enzymes or the proteins. Okay, so first of all, this CRP, a cyclic receptor protein, produces a protein. This CRP actually produces another protein. This is the gene. Okay, if you obviously produce a protein, what is the protein? It is called catabolite activator protein, or in short we can see, right, CAP. CAP protein. Now this CAP binds with the CAMP, that is cyclic AMP. So it will bind with CAMP, this gap. Okay, and it will produce a complex which is the positive regulator. So this is our positive regulator, not the negative one. Okay, now what is this positive regulator do? This complex, this positive regulator, binds at the cap site of the operon. The operon is having total two sites, I have told you. So it will join in the cap site, that is the activating site. Okay. And as a result of which, this cap site is present at the before the promoter region. The promoter region is the where the RNA polymerase comes and binds. So this cap site, suppose here it is a promoter region. So this cap site will be situated at this region. So when this complex is positive regulator comes and binds over here, it influences RNA polymerase to come and bind over here and to synthesize protein. So this is the positive effect of the positive gene. So RNA polymerase enhances the production of the protein. Now, role of glucose. Now, it is being stated, the scientists are from stated that only the production can be increased when there is the carbon content is present only in lactose, not in glucose. So, in presence of glucose, it will not activate, or it will not produce that much protein. So when the glucose is present along with lactose, this glucose is preferentially used and the lactoperon is expressed at a low level because catabolite repression. This glucose suppresses the process. I have told you that only lactose carbon component can increase the rate of the protein synthesis, whereas glucose it will only induce or repress. Next is that the catabolism of glucose is utilized preferentially and sufficient CAMP, that is this one. Glucose when that is present, it will not produce this CAMP, not in a preferential manner. Okay. And as it is not, this CAMP is not there, do you think the positive regulator can form a result of which the entire protein production will be decreased. Okay, so glucose is having a negative impact, whereas this CRP gene, it is playing a positive role or positive gene. It is inducing the process of protein formation. So this is the positive role, and the negative role is that regulatory gene I and the glucose medium. These are the negative impact or negative role of the lac operon. Clear till this much? Now next, I will move on to the human genome project. So, human genome project, or in short, you can write it HGP. Okay. So, what is this human genome project? Before we need to understand human genome, we need to consider on the topic of genome. What is genome? Genome or is the term used to refer all the genes contained in the single cell of single set of chromosome. That means in a single set of chromosome, how many genes are present? That is, in a haploid gamete carried by a single gamete, haploid nucleus carried by the single gamete or reproductive cell. The study of genome is called genomics. We know that we are the diploid organisms. We produce haploid gametes. Haploid gametes means the nucleus of the cell or organelle becomes haploid or half of the mother cell. So, what is genome? In that half set of chromosome, how many genes are present? Okay, number of genes present in each haploid nucleus of the gamete. That is termed as the genome, and the study of genome is the genomics. Okay. Now, genome organization, that means you can say the genetics part or the genetic matter. Virus, we know DNA, RNA both can have. Plants also have some genetic material, generally RNA. DNA can also be found in prokaryotes. It is generally present in the nucleoid. Okay. And it is present in the form of DNA or RNA. Okay. And in the eukaryotes, we have a perfect set of genome. Okay. And this representation or diagrammatic representation. Okay. When you are seeing the set of genome under a microscope, electron microscope, that representation of the chromosomes or the gene under this is termed as the karyotype. Okay, now next we will move on to the significance of genome study. What are the significance of it? Why will we need it? It is the field that has made significant contribution to human health, agriculture, numerous other areas. It has provided the gene sequence necessary to produce medically important proteins through recombinant DNA technology, and it also used in the better understanding of the gene or the genetical composition, as well as to create genetically modified organisms, which is known as GMO. Okay. Now, human genome project is a complete set of genetic information for human, located as DNA sequences within 2 to 3 pairs in the cell nuclei and small DNA molecule found within the individual mitochondria. That means we know that haploid gametes contain 23 chromosomes. So human genome project means it is related with human. It will study the chromosomes, chief among the chromosomes of our haploid gametes. What is the aim of it? First of all, to map the nucleotide present. Okay, mapping the human genome involves sequencing the multiple variations, how many variations we can have. Okay, to find the position of the human genomes and make them available for further biological study, we can easily find out where it is present. Next is that with the understanding of sequence of whole human genotype, it will be understood why the disease is happening, how it can be cured. So we can do all these things. Okay. Next is that we will read about DNA fingerprinting and DNA typing. So what is DNA fingerprinting? First of all, laboratory technique in which a sample of DNA is used in biometrical identification of an individual by examining a person's unique sequence of DNA pairs collected from blood, semen, saliva. Okay, so by studying DNA fingerprinting, we are studying the characteristics of DNA, and we can say that whether this person is related to the other person or not. In this way, we can understand what are the advantages. First of all, is that we can find out who is the father of the child. Okay. Next is that criminal investigation in the forensic department, we can find out. Now, what is the technique? First of all, DNA extraction. DNA is extracted from any body cell. Next is that digestion of DNA with the restriction of endonucleus. So DNA will be dissolved or digested. Next is that agarose gel electrophoresis. The fragments of DNA are separated by size by a gel called electrophoresis. The smaller DNA fragments move faster than the larger fragments. So what will happen? We will break the DNA into several fragments, because it is easy to deal with the smaller fragments of DNA. Next is that southern blotting technique. Here the separate DNA fragments are transferred to a membrane filter, and then it will be probed with a labeled variable number of tandem repeats, and this probe is a DNA or RNA molecule with base sequence complementary with the gene of interest. So it will be identified by keeping it in the blotting paper. Okay, and next is that applications of DNA fingerprinting. So in this way, we can understand the DNA sequences and we can match it up with the required field. So this is all about the DNA fingerprinting and its application, the technique. Hope you have understood the part. So I am keeping till this much. This chapter is over. Okay, thank you everyone.